The House Appointments Committee chaired by Speaker Rebecca Kadaga commenced work at noon. The Uganda Law Society, the Parliament legal team and the Attorney General all gave their legal opinion before the verdict was taken. In their opinion, the Law Society urged that it would be difficult for a UPDF officer to perform his duties without being partisan as provided for by the Political Parties and Organizations Act. The Law Society premised their argument on the Constitution, the Uganda Defense Forces Act 2005, and the Political Parties and Other Organizations Act 2005. However, the lawyers' umbrella body said the committee should use its discretion to decide Aronda's fate and should be mindful of the law. Emotions ran high shortly after the Law Society presented their views, delaying the commencement of the plenary session in the afternoon.
For me, the decision could be made even after that guidance. For me, was very peculiar in our history. We can only say those made the decision to dispense of the law at the expediency of politics, posterity will judge them.
So the main crux of the matter that we're dealing with was actually the issue of partisan. Is cabinet partisan? Yes, it is. And that was the opinion. And we thought that once they say that, our colleagues in the committee would know that the only way to go would be to reject General Ronda's appointment. But to the contrary, they wanted, I think, a chalk and a blackboard to be taught to understand that kind of stuff.
Speaker Rebecca Kadaga decided to put the matter to a vote.
We took an open vote by a show of hands. Those against lost it by 13. I'm advised, and one member abstained. But of course, against an area discussion to bring the matter to the floor to involve members as our rules prescribe. And this was a motion by the Honorable Tada that members, without reason and logic, rejected and used their moribund majority to take the decision.
Rape of the Constitution.
And the precedent it set.
Yet another precedent that we have set. Another reneging on our promise of, as members of Parliament, that we pledge to uphold the Constitution. This is yet another dark day in the history of our politics.
Don't want to go into a situation which would make us look like a military junta. And I am surprised that those people that took a negative decision could not see the danger there is in empowering President Museveni after creating that sad precedent. He can now appoint as many as 15 serving military officers as part of his cabinet.
All the laws were quoted, including the act for the UPDF, and all the relevant provisions were referred to. And when you look at them, there's nothing to say he cannot be appointed a minister.
Buraiha County MP Stephen Kagwera, who is a ruling party MP and according to other sources, abstained, saying the decision set a bad precedent which might be regrettable in the future.
I abstained from voting, but of course it's binding the country because as the committee work on behalf of Parliament and the Parliament works on behalf of the country, I believe it's the wrong precedent we are setting.
The opposition MPs who were not happy with the committee decision tried to raise the matter during the plenary, but the speaker told them to wait for a report. Led by the leader of opposition, Nathan Nandala Mafabi, opposition MPs walked out of parliament in protest.
We believe, to show our discontent, we're not going to be in the house for the next 3 days. As we try to go to court to seek redress. Appointing Aronda, approving Aronda, is a wrong act we did.
There are those who protested, one abstained, and now the opposition has walked out of parliament for the next 3 days. But the fact remains, parliament has approved Aronda as minister. What now remains to be seen is if the constitutional court will overturn the decision. Agnes Nandutu, NTV, Parliament.